Hello. Well, of course it doesn't want to work. There we go. That's a thing. I love that. It's almost a gig for a phone app. That's fucking hilarious. It says, warning, this may incur significant data download. Please download on Wi-Fi. Loud. There we go. Back it down just a touch. Mine. It's almost done. There we go, now it's installing. Apparently, I have to have the latest version of Google Play Games installed. La 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 la. God damn it. I'm trying to load the menu. Because I want, it's like, hey, cool, get Kronika as an announcer, but it's like, it's gonna take fucking forever to set this up. Please, can I skip? No, this is not what I need. Alright, Google, that's not what I wanted. What the hell? I love that. It's telling me to do that. Weird. I don't want to play, I want to do what the thing says. Sorry if this is boring, I'm just trying to get this set up properly. It almost seems like this is MK10 as a mobile app. To play on mobile just so I can try to get access to the settings screen. Like, seriously, there's nothing here. It's like, this is totally MK10 or X. I get it. Can we skip this and get the thing? Like, come on, give me my... Thank you. Because I need the menu. Okay. Skip. I don't want to fight. Give me this. I'm stuck playing the mobile game in order to do what I need to do for that. This is insane. Can I please skip? No? Come on, game, let me skip. Really? Please give me the fucking menu. Give me settings that I can actually use. Like, seriously. Wish you could see this, is really annoying. Can I skip the tutorial, for fuck's sakes? I want the options, for God's sakes. Okay, can we skip the shit? Give me the main menu. Whatever. See why Warner Brothers is getting flack for this game already, and it's not even out for an hour. Okay, can I skip now? Apparently, my name is too long. Settings. Console link. Finally done. wait. Capture. All right, finally. No, I played your beta. It's like, I already know how to play the game unless you've changed it from the beta. Basically everything from the story trailer so far.
Only a matter of time.
bum bum. Basically everything that was in the story trailer. Oh, hello, new footage. Next of kin, Cassie Cage. So we start off with Cassie this time, and she was the finale last time.
Victories have come without cost. Recently, Commander Jackson Briggs was honorably discharged. His wounds, both physical and psychological, left him no longer fit to serve. We honor Jackie's father, and we honor his sacrifice by doing what he
would. Wow, Rhonda sounds too young for this version.
Sergeant Cage.
That's funny. Don't get me wrong, it's cool they have Ronda Rousey in the game, but she sounds way too young to be playing this version.
By Special Forces tradition, you still have to pass one last test. I need to kick the CO's ass, ma'am. Your ass, ma'am. All right, then, Sergeant.
God. Cringe dialogue for that. Out. Oh my God. Okay. Trial by fire, I guess, for this one. And it'd be in the very first fight. What the hell? There we go. Instead of using her dad's actual abilities, she's using the abilities of her drone. That's funny. It's not exactly how military promotions work, but close enough.
Come on, Dad. You really have to go?
Well, you've got your duty, Commander, and I got mine.
Starring in yet another ninja mind support is what I call duty.
I need to be right to you once you become accustomed to that.
Jeez,
guys, I'm
here.
That's kind of interesting. They pretty much hate each other. Hated each other in MKX.
They are irreparably polluted by Shinnok's evil. They are no longer the champions we once knew. Castle is the cathedral of Shinnok, the seat of their power. Destroy it, and their undead army fall, removing its threat to Earthrealm.
Aren't your powers weaker in the Netherrealm?
Yes, but I will have sufficient strength to fight the undead army. That'll buy a
I'm with Johnny on this one. I don't trust Raiden with the Shinnok amulet. This is a setup. And they fixed Cassie so she doesn't look like she's 40 anymore. Meanwhile, Liu Kang and Katana. Yeah, I was gonna say, this is definitely a setup because Raiden sent the head here. It's totally a setup. What the fuck is Raiden up to? Oh, hi, Cabal and Jade. Gotta be weird. Oh. I'll go down. Roger that.
Thank you.
enough with that cabal.
Support columns are further apart than expected. You need help?
Negative. Just watch our back.
10 more minutes. We need it to be taillights in 5. Well, we're in the shit now. Yeah, why? Buy ourselves time. Liu Kang's down here and he is pissed. Oh hey, look, Thomas pissed too. That hurts.
Oh, she got me with her fatal blow. Ooh, that'll hurt. I don't think you guys are going to be able to do much against him. You're right, Luke. Blah. Oh, fuck. I don't exactly have time to grieve. You're out of ammo. And it was all for nothing. Considering Raiden set everything up. Hi, Kronika.
No, Kitana. I am not your friend. Behold. Has been irreversibly tainted by Raiden's actions. Two of you have felt that pain most acutely.
What can be done?
It need not be. I intend to wind time back to its beginning.
The hell? Hi, Colocon. Oh man. Hopefully they overhauled him from MKX, because he was a bastard to fight as. Sword.
Your master is dead. So is his mom. Never again will Calhoun suffer from his corruption.
That's not good. Young Jax, young Sonya, and young Johnny. Oh. Isn't that interesting? She completely butt-fucked corrupted Raiden in a matter of seconds. Scarlet, Aaron Black, Baraka, Kano, and Shao Kahn. So did, wait, Aaron Black, did he die at the end of X? Oh, Long Lin Kang, Young Katana, Young Kung Lao, Young Jade, or live versions, really, and Young Raiden. She ripped a hole in the fabric of time. Because you can see...
defeated Shang Tsung and Quan Chi.
We are decades beyond those events.
For us, they happened only moments ago.
What game are you playing, Raiden? What magic powers this illusion?
If it is a delusion, it is one we all share. Is it possible that the past and future are
collided?
Baraka, Scarlet, all outworld champions long since gone. If you have all returned, has...
I am here, Kotal.
Jade.
Uh-oh.
Requires all refugees be offered assistance. I offer it to you, Shao Kahn.
I am no refugee. I am Khan of Outworld. Vacate my throne, or I'll soak these sands with your blood.
Oh, fuck. Baraka just goes on a massive murder spree because it's Baraka. Of course I don't get to fight Shao Kahn.
Assist and you will die.
body's still just as slow. But at least he's got power moves to counter. Just literally saw people. That's just brutal. Oh, hello. That looked like it was animality, but Kota can turn into a giant puma. Hi, Scarlet. It's also funny considering Scarlet used to be a slave. Fisk. Yeah, so apparently they're an item. So it's young Aaron Black. Thank you. Time to fight Shokan. Wow, Shao Kahn's got some juggle. Gotcha, Shao Kahn. Interrupt his speech. Yes, I did. That's one of his grab moves, because he's Arshtek, so he practices very Mayan ritualistic blood magic. So he will shed his own blood for honor, and then he will have. And then he can consume blood to either heal himself, but because he's also a sun-based deity, he can heal in the sunlight when he casts a beam of light down, and it'll also burn his enemies. Yes, it is. It basically lights them on fire. Like, we're talking fourth degree burns.
I'm this
is it I'm dead and he sits on my throne?
You tried to merge your Earthrealm into Outworld. The Elder Gods intervened and Raiden killed you. That's when Melina became Khan. After this one...
Great.
As are you.
The legends are true.
I am displeased with
shit. There goes the villains teaming up.
I swear to God,
I love this scene from the trailer. Oh fuck, I love that line. I get to play tag team. This is interesting.
Neither will accepting our destiny. destiny as evil undead warlords.
I'm not. But we can't change a future we don't fully understand.
Lord Raiden got us. Can we trust him? It appears he got us both killed.
Uh-oh. Looks like they're a little late. Did they just step on his body? Now, do I get to fight their evil counterparts? Yeah. I get to fight Liu Kang. Where's Liu Kang? Or that.
Easy enough. What's next?
Poison gas.
Wait, no, in the trailer they fight Garrus, don't they? I mean, like that?
I did not do
that. Oh. Hi, Scorpion. Young Scorpion. Let's go Kung Lao.
Can you stop the traps?
Since I do like in more recent Mortal Kombat games, instead of putting it in his hand, it usually just retracts underneath, because at least they explained it in MKX, where they make him human. So he's still able to do a lot of his moves, but they don't go into his hand. His past self, being still of Netherrealm, still has a lot of the supernatural abilities like Flamehead. Like that. Him and his giant flame skeleton. Oh, so nice to see Kung Lao's abilities. I love his abilities from 9. I missed it in X. He was one of my favorites to play. Ow. Oh, he got me with his fatal blow. Kind of. He always was, even in 9. Oh, he blocked it. Hey, look, it's the first time I've actually died. Ow. So yeah, they changed it up a bit. Power meters are a little different now. Instead of one central power meter for everything, you have two defensive meters, two offensive meters to give yourselves boosts, and then your X-ray, as they used to call it, is now called Fatal Blow, which means you can only use it when you hit 30% health or less. Get knocked out. Well, I could have chosen to play as Liu Kang, and it would have been Kung Lao is just as useless. By the way, that feature comes from Injustice 2, where you get to choose between which fighters you want to play in certain situations. Because there are certain times where you'll have tag teams, where you can choose which character you want to fight in that particular fight. So. Future Jade. And it also makes you decide the fate of Earth in Injustice. Let's go with Liu Kang this time. So in Injustice 2, instead of sending Billy after him, or in the first Injustice, have good Superman fight evil Superman, Batman has infused his armor with kryptonite. And you have to either choose a side. You can either help rebuild Earth as Batman, or you can have Superman take his revenge on Batman and return everything back to the way it was when Joker murdered Lois. So, I kind of chose the good ending over the evil ending. And part of the problem with Injustice 2 is the Earth was going to get wiped out anyway because Brainiac was there. So yeah, in this fight, I'm fighting Future Jade, who's a revenant. Whereas there's young Jade, who's in love with Kotal Kahn. Injustice 1 was Joker plants a bomb in Metropolis. No, it wasn't Luther. It was Batman. What you're thinking of is the beginning of DC Universe Online when Luther went back in time and seeded the Earth with powers. Injustice 1 dealt with parallel realities. Because Batman went and summoned the good Justice League from regular Earth to fight in his war with Superman. Injustice 2 is the eventuality of the Injustice Universe hitting Brainiac. Well, I love that. DC Universe Online had a great intro, great premise, but a very shitty execution. Gotcha. And Marvel's clone of it wasn't much better. In fact, it was worse that it died within like 6 months. Whoa, leg. You saw it, right? How it just kind of slowed down for a little bit. At least this time coming out wasn't useless. And apparently City of Villains is becoming a thing, as Artie's been explaining in the Evil Inc. Discord. Apparently someone released the code so that the private server could then become public. Yeah, the guy who ran the private server, he gave up on trying to run it himself, so he released his code so anybody can make it now. I would love that for Matrix Online. I never got to play it. I wanted to. Oh, fuck. You must find Kronika's key and gain control of her hourglass. Only then. See, I never got to play Matrix Online, so like for me, the only games I had were Path of Neo, really. And I tried Enter the Matrix and didn't like it. So basically, SOE bought it, turned it to shit. Oh, god damn it. Hearing about this just makes me want to play that. Oh hey, look. Revenant Liu Kang and Revenant Kung Lao. Liu Kang versus Liu Kang. Ah, damn it. It sounds something similar Cryptic would do, but Star Trek has similar events. It's just lately they've gotten microtransaction happy, so it's some of the things were nicer before they started making it. You had to farm shit. Like the new recent event they just announced, it's like, oh hey look, this is going to take you at least 3 months to do, and you're only going to get tiny amounts of credits per day doing the new fleet operation to get enough tokens in order to get the free ship. And then they did the same thing, like the anniversary events. It was almost instant. You played the story mission, you got a free ship. And then they made it, oh, well, because everybody's exploiting it like crazy, they made it you get 400 credits, and then you have to do all the stupid little other things per day just to have the 1,000 credits you need to get the free ship, making the anniversary event kind of pointless other than for story. It's his trademark move. He's got a razor hat. In MK9, it was more brutal because it had little blades attached to it so that it would look like a giant saw blade. Last thing, in terms of... Oh, that. Yeah, no, that is lame for Cryptic. Because like what happened was is when Cryptic got bought by Arc / the guys who do Neverwinter, it was okay for a while, and then all of a sudden, like more within the last couple of years, they just made it so it's like, oh, you gotta farm all this shit, and the tokens you get in the anniversary events are limited time tokens that you can only use during those events, and they don't carry over to the next event. And then, like, then they also have the other microtransactions that were there in the beginning of the game many, many years ago, which were the lockboxes. And the only way to open a lockbox was to get an actual key that you had to pay real money for. So it's like, they've basically made it so that the free-to-play players are only realistically getting story stuff. And if you want, you know, good shit, you have to basically farm in order to get the free stuff. Or pay the money, really. Well, they did it that way, and I'm like, why? It was more fun the other way. Like, the free-to-play players would get, you know, a nice taste of what the subscription players were getting. And like more recently, I farmed the living shit out of dilithium in order to get a fleet ship. And then a lot of the same consoles I used to use in weapon mods became obsolete when they completely overhauled the story system. Where they're like, oh hey, these missions that you used to be able to get really good gear with, they're gone. They're like, if you want really good gear, you have to basically craft it. And the crafting system takes fucking forever because you have to obtain the necessary marks to make it work. Right now, it's not really interesting to play Star Trek Online because it's all Discovery crap. The only interesting part is they brought back Mirror Universe Tilly, who's known as Captain Killy, and her mission is two-parter mission and a TFO. And then they're like, yeah, we're doing Mirror of Discovery for the entire season. And I'm like, okay, where's the story content? So far, you've only released two TFOs and a two-parter mission. How is that a season? Last season was amazing. Last season had Deep Space Nine, and it had, like, at least 8 or 9 missions for it. It was like, what the hell happened? All of a sudden, we go from a major expansion like DS9 to a very shitty, haphazard slap shit together for Discovery. They do have quite a bit of that. There's an entire story arc dealing with the Temporal Prime Directive. There's even a part where you have to go back in time and assist Archer's Enterprise. So... and you even get to play with Cal Dano for a bit. Like, there's an entire mission arc where Cal Dano comes back in time because the Tholians have fucked with time again. Just random. I'm gonna look down. But I haven't seen that. There are times where Section 31 has intervened because of a temporal problem. But they kind of dropped that after a while in STO. Because there's a couple times we have to go back in time on behalf of Section 31. But they kind of abandoned it after a while, especially when you get the USS Postdoc on board as a regular thing in the time travel paradox. Because there's an entire campaign called Temporal Agent, but they're not Section 31. You're just drafted by the Future Federation to fix problems in the timeline. Because they introduced more Voyager stuff with the Krenim. Because the Krenim keep fucking with time as always, but this time it's actually, kind of? It's more of just a sort of, like, weird veiny thing. It almost looks like Suliban. But Daniels, even then, like, he pops up, but he's not your contact. Daniels just shows up as your guide. And a lot of the things that you do with some of the future stuff is dealing with the directly with the Federation, not with Section 31. Like when they bring you on board to try to, you know, witness peace talks. And, Scorpion and Sub-Zero. Now this is future Sub-Zero and Scorpion, so they're human. And yes, Steve Bloom plays Sub-Zero again.
Time disruption. Now, Sector's returned and reactivated it. He's building an army by processing Lin Kuei warriors kidnapped from my temple.
I can see why.
Now, the reason a certain character that's going to show up, probably in the next few minutes, is voiced by a different person.
And the rest of your plan.
Is because the original voice actor is now the announcer. So, but yeah, Daniels is more of a point of contact, but only as in Like, he's important to the thing, but he's very, very busy dealing with a specific problem that you eventually have to deal with as well. So, he might be Section 31, but he's probably the nicest fucking Section 31 guy there is. Because he almost never has an ulterior motive. Whereas, there's a Section 31 contact in STO, and he always has an ulterior motive. But yeah, with the Federation, they directly contact you and bring you to the future as a temporal agent. Because so many things start happening within the 25th century, because it's 2410 roughly when everything takes place. Yeah, that was the thing. Everyone kind of surmised that. But STO expands upon the lore considerably. Like, one of my favorite shield configurations in the game is Raymond. And when you apply it to Federation technology, it looks fucking amazing. It gives it, like, a mirror sheen, but at the same time, it gives it, like, this Borg green glow that makes it look awesome. So I chop everybody in half. Oh, hey, Cyrex. But, yeah, they expand upon the lore quite a bit in the game. Like, they even explain what happens to Data. Well, yeah, it's because what they're doing is they're taking the bodies apart, taking the brains, and throwing the brains into cybernetic bodies. Basically, harvesting. Hi, Frost. Let's go with Sub-Zero since I played Scorpion in the beta. But yeah, in terms of the beta for this game, I actually liked playing as Scorpion because he was pretty well balanced. Swords this time? Throw her into an ice ceiling. Because in two different regions, this game is now banned. Japan banned it for too much gore, and China is now going to probably end up banning it for similar reasons, because they've just released new standards for their version of the ESRB that states that anything that's considered too violent is now banned in their country. So, let's go with Scorpion. Yeah, Japan banned it because apparently it's too much gore. At least with Australia, they came out with a brand new rating so that people could still fucking buy it. They came out with the X rating because, especially for MK9, so that people could actually buy the game. Because people in Australia and New Zealand were getting pissed off that they were being basically censored from games that they want to play. Well, they see, that's the thing, is their views on sex is very different than that of North America. Like, even in the UK, they don't care about nudity in most things, even though they have a porn filter. But in terms of, like, TV content in the UK, to them, a little bit of nudity is fine. It's mostly when you have, like, grievous bodily harm do they start to get a little antsy. But at the same time, they still enjoy playing violent video games, and it's not a problem for them. I mean, hell, look at fucking Germany. They'll show orange juice ads like they did in Eurotrip with completely topless women because they know it sells. Uh-oh. That's not Sektor. That's the voice change. Bin Han. Yep. It's Noob Saibot. I'm gonna go with Scorpion since I know the character better from the beta. One of the models I follow really loves Noob Saibot, so she was like very excited that Noob was coming back. She doesn't really do cosplay so much, except maybe Harley, but she primarily just focuses on modeling. Probably would have made more sense if it was, you know. Sub-Zero fighting this fight, but whatever. That's nice that they put interactions in for Scorpion, at least, for him. Notice how that one is blue behind him. Does that mean that's supposed to be Sub-Zero? Like Cyber Sub-Zero. Possibly. Well, that's how we want to put it as. If you're curious about the storyline in these games, check out 9, 10, and 11. Trust me, Yeah, because in MK9, he was Cyber Sub-Zero. Hi, Sector. This kind of does make sense, you know, fire with ice, as opposed to fire against fire. So they actually made them separate characters in this one. It's actually interesting. Because in MKX, what they did was, as a DLC character, they introduced both Cyrax and Sector as Triborg, where you could face off as Cyrax, Sector, or Smoke, and if you knew the secret command in 10 or X, you could become Cyber Sub-Zero as a carryover from MK9. But they decided to make them separate characters again in this one, which is interesting. Because I thought it was actually a pretty cool idea for them to make it as Cyrax, Sector, Smoke, and Cyber Sub-Zero were all one character with the same moveset. It was just when you chose each variation, it would have their particular abilities. Was cool of MK Legacy to include the MK9 or MKX designs. I think it was 9, as the versions they had in Legacy, which was a mini series on Machinima. And then apparently Warner Brothers was like, I think it was Warner Brothers or New Line, one of the companies was like, hey, look, we still have a deal for a third movie. You want to make the third movie for us? And then nothing ever happened. But Legacy was a pretty good miniseries that they eventually released as a movie.
Can you restore him?
There's some frame damage. Circuitry looks good.
Anything's possible with the right help.
Serve Kronika and she will provide.
Oh, crap. There's future Kano.
Otherwise, who can you trust? You weren't kidding. It's like a mirror reflecting the past.
How about that? Over 50 and still a ripper.
Come on, guys, you could basically might as well get a room at this point. Oh, and if you don't know that, that's Jackie Briggs. Probably. I think they tried doing that with Archer at one point.
I know my dad's still alive. It's like I'm seeing a ghost.
You and me both. They're definitely real.
Can this get any more?
But yeah, that's Jackie Briggs. Jax's daughter. Just like Cassie is Johnny and Sonya's kid. Yeah, I'm gonna be going to bed soon anyway. Because I gotta get up somewhat early. Well, earlier than normal, but because I have a job interview at 2. Have a good one, Paul. We'll see. It's down in Woodstock. Oh, the cell network's just fucked as all. Go down there, Jax. Like, fuck, don't stay at home. Jax, go down there. What the fuck? Would you get PTSD? Full beer. What are you doing at Jax's place, Kronika?
Jackson Briggs. Do not fear. I have come to offer you a new life. A better life.
That's awfully generous. Seeing as we never met.
We have not met. How valiantly you served.
Your plan?
You were to retire the General Jackson Briggs. More importantly, your daughter was not to serve nor endure the same tragedies you have. Your home is filled with grandchildren. Help me, and it will be.
Oh, crap.
Shalcon's escape.
Please advise me of what you do. I must consult with the Elder Gods.
When do we leave?
Your support is critical against both Kronika and Shao Kahn. Sure. Shiva is not trusting. All Shao Kahn has is my bloody battle with Kronika.
I always respect your opinion more than anyone's. When she hears you support Kronika, she'll join us.
Thank you.
Are you my friend or his consort? It was my idea, Kitana. It's in your best interest. Succeed with Shiva and Koda will pledge his loyalty to you. There's no bond more sacred to an archer like you.
Life has changed as Outworld's call. Thankfully, you have not.
You have. You're still the same noble warrior I met in Shao Kahn's court. And now you're Kahn. I'm surprised no woman has claimed your bed and become your queen.
Many have tried.
Yes, they failed. Why?
None of them.
There are fresh tracks leading into the hive. If Shao Kahn's in there, we'll have to find
much less what is in there. Jade versus Jade. She got the fatal blow on me. Thank you. Alright, I'm gonna call it here because I gotta get up early in the morning. So thanks to everybody who came out, thanks to Paul. Have a good one. I'll probably be at this again tomorrow.
Choose your destiny. Flawless victory.